Okay, Assalamualaikum. We will continue with this particular project whereby I'm going to paint the wild roses on this double switch plate. Okay, I'm going to base each of the petal with this light buttermilk Americana. We will proceed using this stay wet palette and also round brush. So let me check. Maybe I should use a smaller brush number 2 instead of the big brush. Okay, I'm going to use a round brush number 3. So this light buttermilk, and we just baste it onto the petal. So it's soft white against a light buttermilk is almost similar in color, but nevertheless, we still need to baste it first. Okay, just going to do this. There's only 3 flowers actually. So we're going to cover the pencil mark as well. Okay, once we have it based for one layer, we were going to coat a second layer, but before that, we should dry it first. Okay, and then we'll do a second layer using the same brush and same color. And the last one here, the last flower. Okay, we're done with the second layer. Dry it again. Okay, and then after that we are shading it. So in order to shade, I'm going to use antique mouth, Americana. Shade with a bit of pink. We're going to use angle brush, 3/8. And also a retarder. I'm going to put it onto the palette. We're going to soak the angle brush with a retarder first. Okay, instead of using water. And then we're going to tip with the antique mouth. Okay. And you're going to shade along the side there. Okay. Okay, so we have that already been colored. And we take again. And we're going to do the same for the others. Okay. Take some more. And we're going to do it onto the other one. Then that last part, yeah. So we have colored it like that. Okay, and then we take burnt sienna. I'm taking burnt sienna. We take lamp black, okay? We take lamp black because I'm going to shade gray on the middle portion, okay? So we're going to mix a bit of white and black to get a bit of grayish color. We don't want it to be too strong. The gray must be just a light gray, okay? Before that, I think we should dry first. We dry onto this one first. Okay, and then we're gonna take the gray color just now. Put a bit of retarder. And we're gonna shade in the middle, yeah? Okay, we're gonna make it a bit stronger. Better gray, yeah. Yeah. Okay, we're gonna do just that around it. Okay, so we have the middle portion, which is a bit of gray. Okay, so now we dry it. And then we're gonna use a quarter inch this deer foot brush, yeah. So I'm gonna use cadmium yellow. And a bit of burnt sienna. Okay. So we're gonna take burnt sienna at the bottom of the brush, and the top is the cadmium yellow. Yeah, I'm gonna test it first. Okay, so we're gonna do it here. Okay, and a bit more. And here, okay, and then here, okay, we're gonna put a bit more yellow. Okay, so we got that. Okay, and then after that, we're gonna line it. Let me get the tissue paper first. My hands are a bit dirty. We're gonna take a liner brush. Okay, I'm gonna use this liner brush and use a bit of black and white, so to get a bit of gray, and I'm gonna draw lines. Like that. Yeah. So it's going to be that way, okay. You have to have a bit of water on the brush. And you go and have it drawn lines in gray color. Same thing with the others. Okay. And then draw like that. Okay, so you have all done up that way. Okay, and then we take burnt sienna just now on the brush, and we put dots onto it. Yeah. Little dots, like it's a pollen. Okay, so we have put a little dotted, if you watch it, I have put a little dots here and there. So that would be the complete feature of this particular wild roses. Okay, so we dry it. Okay, then the next part I'm going to do is the buds. Okay, so the buds I'm just going to use a quarter inch angle brush. Sorry, this is not quarter inch, this is 3/8. So I'm going to baste it, the bottom part with antique moth, and the top part is the light buttermilk. Huh? So I'm just going to do buds here. Okay, and also here. And this I think that's about it, yeah. These are the two buds that we're going to put. Okay, and dry it. Okay, and then I'm going to use the bit of pine green. This is Joe Sonia color. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the angle brush just now. I'm going to tip it with pine green, and bottom part is a bit of yellow, cadmium yellow. Okay, so I'm just going to do the buds. Okay. So you've got the buds there and there. Okay. Then I'm gonna shade a bit around the flower using raw sienna. I don't have raw sienna. Okay, let me get raw sienna first. Okay, we'll do the shading. Okay, we have to put a dip in our brush with Joe Sonia retarder to make sure that it doesn't get dry too fast in order to shade. And I will tip with the color Joe Sonia raw sienna. Yeah. So we just want to have just a soft color raw sienna, so that we can just shade around the flower and the leaves. Okay, I'm going to just shade here and there with raw sienna. If it's too dry, you can just dip into the retarder. Like so, yeah. Just going to put here and there only. Put a bit more retarder to it, so that it will soften up the color. Okay. Okay, so I have shaded around the flower, some parts with raw sienna. Okay, and then we're gonna dry it properly. Okay. So once we have it dry, we can use a liner brush and dark chocolate to do the stem and tendrils. I'm going to mix a bit with burnt sienna, yeah, so that it won't get too dark. So we're going to have the okay, like so. Okay, and then we're going to do the tendrils. Okay, we're going to do just the tendrils. So we have all the tendrils done up like that. So we are about to complete it. Except that I think I'll just add a bit by using this particular color, which is Antique Mauve, using the liner brush. I'm just going to draw a bit of lines at the edge of the flower, yeah? Just to have a bit more defined in terms of the petals. Okay, I have it a bit more defined. Okay. Then one more. Okay, so I have the complete picture done up. That would be it for today. We will continue again to finish up the rest either tomorrow or after Hari Raya. Okay, thanks for watching.